Evolution, everybody. You're watching on Facebook Live. I noticed the other day that I have this weird thing where I always clap my hands together and do this every time, so I'm gonna try and stop doing that. Welcome. Super excited about the show today. A little bit sad as well. This will be my last live show of the year for obvious reasons. Having a baby any day now. Found out this morning we are head down and engaged. Also really excited, my guest today. If we want to talk about Bulletproof, my guest is exactly that. Like, she has taken what a lot of people would look at as a very, very scary situation and is making the most out of it and healing herself in ways that I couldn't even imagine. So, highly recommend sharing this video, of course. I want to grow. I want you guys to grow. So getting this message out is very, very important to me, hopefully very important to you as well. So click the share button, like, comment. If you do comment right now, we can answer your questions live. So if not, we'll get back to you later, no big deal. So let's get to my guest. Oh my gosh, I hope we blow your mind today. Well, she's gonna blow your mind. Yeah, Anuschka Alborzian.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. So life empowerment coach. You weren't always that, though, correct?
No, I was actually a computer science and engineering major. So all my life I've been in the computer world. And then last August, I was diagnosed with a pretty bad brain tumor. It was, and then a prognosis, which I completely do not believe in. And I will, one of the main reasons why I'm so passionate now about becoming, you know, like empowering other people, is because of the prognosis, really. So the prognosis they told me was, oh, you have only 3 to 5 years to live. And I was like, oh, really? Watch me. And so therefore, like, I just took everything on, from subconscious healing to, you know, power of love, forgiving, and not only forgiving others, but also forgiving myself. And so that's really like what I've been doing in the past year and couple months now, is just focusing on everything that I possibly can to make sure that I heal, especially because I'm going through chemotherapy. I just finished my third to last chemo cycle on Friday, so two more to go. I'll be done by the end of this year. So, and that's what this is for. It's additional stuff, but I'm still like full force, you know, empowering other people and making sure that, you know, they don't sit here and believe these. You know, I'm not saying, not to say doctors, you know, are bad or anything, but sometimes you have to look at it as an individual, and I want to have that empowerment for other people and actually have them have a voice and be able to be their own self-advocate.
Absolutely, because you know you better than anyone else. Exactly. Better than anyone. They have all the medical stuff, which is great, but you've lived with yourself your whole life. And so walk us through, like, how you found out, because I think that's a pretty intense story.
Yeah,
with whatever you feel comfortable with, of
definitely
course.
Yeah, I'm very open. I actually share very publicly because I want people to be very aware of what it is. I was very healthy, you know, like pretty positive, I would say, for the most part, and, you know, exercise all the time. I've had that in my life, so it was very shocking. But it wasn't always like that. I had a lot of anger, I had a lot of resentment, I was not the happiest when I was in my early 20s, and so my guess is a lot of that is what brought it up to be to like this avocado sized brain tumor. Yeah, it was like literally when I saw the picture, it was a fourth of my brain. And I remember seeing that and being like, how am I standing here? You know, like it was crazy. So how I actually realized that, okay, I need to go to the doctor, is I started getting these random headaches. And then I kept Googling, it's like, oh, migraine, and, you know, which I always say, like, now, like, you have something that's not normal, go to the doctor just to get tested, because, you know, everything in Google suggested that it was a migraine. Everything. Mm-hmm. Even the doctor that I finally went to after 4 months of these headaches and throwing up, I went to the doctor, and she actually said she had a hunch, and that's what had her have me take an MRI. Otherwise, like, other doctors might have been like, you know what, here's some migraine prescriptions.
Yeah.
You know, so, and then when I got the MRI, I literally went straight from MRI, and I was planning on going to play volleyball after, so I was like, oh, this will just be a peace of mind, but no, that's not what happened. It went from like 15 minutes to all of a sudden an hour later, and they're like, okay, you're going to have to go to the emergency room. I'm like, okay. And I was able to be really present. And mm-hmm. I think that's really important in anything in life, because at that point, if I was going to freak out, what was that going to do to me other than like create like even more anxiety, you know? And so I went to the emergency room, called my husband, he came, and then from there we went to the ICU room. They had to reduce the swelling because of the size, and then 5 days later, we had the surgery. And yeah, it was, I would say the whole thing was pretty magical. They, you know, I know it sounds crazy.
Right, yeah.
That's why I call it a rebirthing, because like it completely changed my perspective on life, the value of life, you know, and just really like I noticed how important it is, because I literally wasn't allowing anybody in that room unless they were pure love, you know? And I was like, if you have just love to give to me, you're welcome to come. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, I'm like, no, you know?
Yeah.
So I set my boundaries and I was very specific about that. And yeah, and they said it was gonna take about 3 weeks or something, 3 to 4 weeks for me to get out of the hospital. I was out from beginning to end 10 days.
Wow.
Yeah.
Just from having that loving environment mm-hmm. and being so intentional with what you really wanted with your experience.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. So what's been going on since then? So you had this, in case you didn't catch that, an avocado-sized tumor, got it removed.
Mm-hmm. The whole thing was removed, thankfully.
Uh-huh. Yeah. So you're getting chemotherapy, mm-hmm, and then you said mm-hmm. you've been doing all types of other practices and self-love.
Yes, yes. So my thing is like, go within. Like, I did go based on my intuition. It wasn't like, oh, doctor said you got to do radiation and chemo, and I said, yes, sir, you know? No, it was more of like, I went within, and I realized, hey, no, that is something that my body needs. Because of the diagnosis, you know, because of how, and it got escalated too, by the way. And they didn't even tell me the diagnosis for like 6 weeks too. That was the other. So it was just a lot of like, just, you know, just being with and like just being in the moment and just, you know, just knowing that, hey, everything is going to work out for me. And that's what I remember constantly telling myself, is everything is going to work out. Everything's going to be fine, you know? And so, yeah, I went through radiation, and then I went, started the whole chemotherapy. And yeah, it's almost been a year now of that. But on top of that, that's only a small portion of what I've been doing. I do all kinds of supplements. Like, I'm literally like, I wake up like with those big, like, you know, those pill things that,
pill
those,
boxes,
yeah,
those, yeah.
I literally have the ones with like four rows, mm-hmm. like, and each one is like packed. And I have like my shakes in the morning, like that's like my huge thing. It's not just shakes though, I'm like pouring all kinds of stuff in there as well.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like
fruits and
fruits and like just other supplements, okay. You know, liquid iron, you know, all kinds of things just to keep my energy going and have me like be able to be here. Because I mean, I literally just finished, you know, chemo Friday night. This weekend I was just like, oh, you know, now I'm like, let's do this. I'm back, you know. But that's been a huge part. And then, yeah, like a lot of the self, I do a lot of energy work. I'll go to different, you know, whether it's like EFT tapping or, you know, work with actual energy light workers, you know, I'll go Reiki. Like I went to Wally.
So
yes,
right.
I went to Wally. Yes, I saw her last week.
Wally was on the show with us last week.
Yeah. Yes,
I saw her. In case you didn't get that. So if you don't know what Reiki is, you can go and go back a week.
Yes, she's great. So yeah, I mean, it's definitely a full-time job and then some.
Yeah, I can imagine.
And I'm trying to, you know, build my business at the same time, so. People think I'm crazy, I know.
You're not. You're you. But yeah, I mean, you think the amount of people who go into that such a fragile state and, oh, poor me.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's a big deal to have that, you know? I mean, how many people die from cancer?
Yeah. Yeah.
On a regular basis. So, but what an awesome way to go about it. Just like, nope, you're not taking me down. So a year later, and how are we looking? Because they were giving you, you said 3 to 5 years?
Well, that's what they said. Mm-hmm. And I mean, I've been getting my MRIs every 3 months. It was every 2 months, but they like were like, oh yeah, and you're good to go every 3 months now for mm-hmm. like a while. And I mean, every time it's been clear, no enhancements.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I feel like I'm done. I feel like it's all gone. There's nothing
good
there. And I've like, you know, talked to different energy workers and whatnot, and everybody's like, yeah, you're cured, you're fine. You know, even my doctor's like, yeah, you'll be cured, you know, like,
yeah.
And he's like medicine side, right? And mm-hmm. even he's like saying that. But that's the other thing. Like, I'm very big on letting people know that like be your own self-advocate. This is my third oncologist. I didn't just stick with that first one. You know, I literally kept, you know, going to different ones to be like, hey, let's see if this, me and this person vibe, if we have the same, because the one before was like, oh, this type of tumor never goes away. I'm like, I don't want somebody like that working with me. Like, why would I work with somebody like that, you know? Or like even just the whole prognosis thing, like I said, unfortunately that makes people lose so much hope, and I want to get that voice out there that like, no, just because these stats say something doesn't necessarily mean that that's that. I mean, yes, there's work involved, like I'm wearing this, it's not pretty, you know, I'm like gone organic vegan for the most part, you know, unless I crave something, because then I know my body's needing something. Yeah. But it's like, I mean, it takes hard work, but it's like work for your life. Right. You know, so it's worth it, you know? I mean, if you believe that you're worth it, then, you know, you're going to do everything you possibly can, right?
And it's not comfortable, but how many people won't make those lifestyle changes because it's uncomfortable?
Uncomfortable, yeah. Exactly.
That's awesome. Yeah. So you basically, you're giving those you're showing the doctors who's boss right now.
Like, yes.
You told me 3 to 5 years, but that's not what's happening here.
Watch me.
Yeah. So let's talk about forgiveness.
Yes.
You know, we've got a little emotional, I guess we're kind of talking about the emotional aspect of health and considering what you've been going through. You said forgiveness has been a huge part of your healing process.
Yes.
So what exactly is forgiveness? Because I know some people are just like, nope, this person did me wrong. My mama knows about it. We're not turning back.
Totally.
They hold grudges and it's so bad for us. Mm-hmm. So how has it helped you in your healing?
For me, because I was that too. You know, I would have resentments for like for a long time and I would just not let it go. And so there's two things with that. So there's forgiveness of others and then forgiveness of yourself. So for forgiveness with others, like one of the things I really, and I did this through one of my talks, or for that, you know, that talk that you were at, venting out what's there is very key. Because if you're pretending like it's not there and then you're just resisting it, well, that's just going to make it stronger. Mm-hmm. So it's okay to vent about it and, you know, like actually like say, hey, well, this is, and, you know, really taking that victim attitude for like a short period, and just getting it all out.
Get it out.
Yeah, just get it out. Get it out. Whether it's, you know, to someone else or writing it out. Mm-hmm. Not in your head, because then you're just going to go crazy, right? Like, you want to get it out. So just get it out. And then after that, actually, like, looking, and there's, like, some tools that I've been learning in this program that I'm in, which I'm not going to share here, because they're actually intellectual property. Mm-hmm. But it really is just, like, there's a process. There's very different processes that you can go through to really do that. What I actually shared with everybody at my talk was, you know, get it all out, and then take, like, you know, 10 different things that you really love or, you know, acknowledge about that person and just look, you know, focus on that. And a lot of times that helps release it, right? Because forgiving is not for the other person. You can just say, hey, I forgive you and I just still don't want to have anything to do with you. There's nothing wrong with that. I actually have been doing that more than ever now because I believe in creating boundaries and I believe in being surrounded with people that, you know, make me feel good. And if that's not the case, like, I love you, but I, you know, send you off with love, you know? Mm-hmm. It's really that for me. So that's, I think, a huge thing to just like, get it out, like, no matter what. And then just look at all the things that they do have positively and just know that they probably didn't do it anything against you. A lot of times it's like whatever they're dealing with, whatever triggers they have,
your,
you know?
Perception of
it. And then our, exactly. And then we have our own filters, right? We all have like a lens that we live our life through. And so it's like you have this filter and you're like, and it might even be like a mirror that you're seeing something in this person that like frustrated you. And then it's like, oh, well, why is it frustrating me? Because if somebody called me a boy, I wouldn't get frustrated, right? Mm-hmm. It's like, no, I'm not a boy. So what is it that's frustrating me? And so just being really clear with that, I think it helps a lot because I know I notice like sometimes things come up for me. Mm-hmm. And then for yourself too, like I think that's a huge one. A lot of times people are like angry at themselves because I don't know, like they didn't do something they wanted to do or whatever it is, it's they didn't meet their own expectations of themselves. That's what it comes down to. Mm-hmm. And just knowing that, hey, this is my path and it's fine to not be where I said that I was gonna be. You know, I had learned something actually recently, like last week, And it was like, instead of saying, I have to do this, it's like saying, I prefer to do this. I prefer to get, a, you know, X, Y, Z done and leave it at that. And if I don't get it done, it's not like this, I have to do this. And it's like, if I don't, I'm not perfect. And nobody's perfect, right? So
I beg to differ there. I think everyone is perfect.
Well, like, you know, we're all perfect. We're
we have imperfections.
We're perfectly imperfect.
There we go.
That's what I like to say, is we are perfectly imperfect because, you know, we're all going to have our own, like, you know, flaws and whatnot, but that doesn't mean that we're, like, bad people or whatever it is, you know?
Still, it's you.
Yeah.
It's you. Love it.
And you end up, like, making these, like, mistakes here and there in life. It's okay. You learn from them, you know? You learn from, sometimes it may take 10 years to learn from the same mistake, and therefore you repeat those patterns, but hey, maybe that's what you needed to do, you know?
Yeah. I want to reiterate two things that you said, and the first one is that venting is okay.
Yes.
Get it out. Don't leave it in.
Release.
Write it out. Go
cry,
talk to someone about it. Get it out, but don't hang on to it. I think there's a lot of people who vent, and then they vent to the next person, they vent to the next person, they don't let it go.
Mm-hmm.
But get it out. Get the feelings out. Move on with your life. And I don't want to say just move on, but accept it, and sometimes that can be
That's hard. That's why I call it art of forgiveness, because it's like, it takes time. It takes, like, practice. It takes, like, sometimes it does take repetitive, you know, times of, like, venting it out.
Yeah.
It's not going to happen in, like, one time, depending, of course, you know. Yeah. Sometimes it could be something small, but just depends on the situation.
Yeah.
You know?
And then leading into the second part, which is, you know, what you're just saying, the forgiveness is about you. It's not about them.
Mm-hmm.
It's about letting...
Speaking of which, I want to
then go
quote
for it.
That I was. So I had this quote. I thought it was perfect. A saint was asked, "What is anger?" He gave a beautiful answer. "It is a punishment we give to ourselves for somebody else's mistake."
Yeah.
Isn't that like
yeah.
so? Like I remember I read that and I was like, oh, I got goosebumps from it because it really is. It's like. That happened. It's in the past, and now I'm continuing to bring it in the present over and over and over again.
Forgiveness is for you to find peace and move on with your life, to let go of whatever that other person did. And how many times do we get angry with someone and then realize that, you know what, they were just doing what they thought was best.
Yep.
And we didn't, you know, it wasn't our expectation of what we thought was best.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, oh my gosh, that's amazing. I love that. So, in, like, I have a question, how do I ask it right now? So, your journey with forgiveness, you had to heal some, you know, some things in your past and, you know, things that you went through, letting go of.
Yeah.
Which...
And myself. I had to forgive myself for the decisions I made when I was younger. Because I did have, like, not the best relationship. I mean, now I have, like, an absolutely amazing husband. I love him so much. Like, he's super supportive. And, like, that wasn't the case, you know, years ago. And so I allowed, you know, those things. Like, I would make myself wrong about it. Like, why were you so weak? Why were you so this? Why, you know, all those things were there. And I had to learn that, hey... It's okay. It's like literally like asking like a kindergartner to be like, come on, do calculus, you know?
You can't. Why don't you know this? I don't even know calculus, dang it.
Yeah. So it's like, you can't expect that, right? So it's the same thing. It's like, how can I expect my, you know, 17, 18 year old self to have known all the like, you know, wisdom and knowledge that I have now? I just can't.
She pretty much just answered the question without me even asking it. What I was trying to say is, how is forgiving yourself led to the forgiving of other people?
Oh, yeah. So I think that's, like, a huge thing, actually. When you forgive yourself for a lot of the different things, you'll notice, like, you'll actually end up releasing a lot of the forgiveness you have for other people, because sometimes there's things out there that you think it's about the other person, but in reality, it's right here with you.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, I think it's a lot of times, but...
Most of the time.
Like, it's literally like a mirror, you know? Like, the people in our lives are mirrors. And, you know, whatever we see in others that triggers us, that's something within us for us to actually deal with. And actually, like, I've come, because I've been very emotional lately due to my hormonal imbalance and whatnot.
You
and
me
so,
both, girl.
Yeah, I know. I'm like, is this what it's like to be pregnant? Like, I'm going to be crying all the time.
Maybe.
But I've been realizing it's actually I'm grateful for it because it allows me to see what's there to heal still, mm-hmm. you know, because and then when I'm not like emotional and I'm in my higher self, like those things don't come up. Those triggers don't come up because I'm like, oh, I'm good. Everything's great. Everybody's right. awesome. But and then when I hit those like low moments is when like I'll still notice. I'm like, oh, they're still about to heal. Okay, cool. Okay, let's work on this, you know, and so that's actually like a good way to be like, hey, this is cool. You know, be grateful for it because it's like looking at something new to heal.
That's funny. I've been kind of going through the same process with being pregnant and getting ready for birth, just getting rid of like little fears that, you know, that could potentially cause issues when the, you know, time for baby to come.
Yeah.
So what are you working on now? Because you know, you said before you were doing computer science.
Yes.
And now you're a life empowerment coach.
Yes. So interestingly enough, I got laid off a few weeks ago from Qualcomm.
Oh.
So, you know how the universe just provides and like literally like sometimes they say the universe will push you into a direction that you're, because I mean, there of course as anything else, there was some fear there. And I'm very clear I manifested getting laid off. I'm clear because mm-hmm. I like, every time I thought about going back to work, I was like, So now I've been in a program for the last several months and it's absolutely amazing. I've been getting all kinds of training and coaching tools to really be able to do exactly what I desire to do, and that's empower others in any area of their lives, and really just like, you know, as a life coach would. But my specific focus is empowerment. So that's what I've been working on with a lot of my clients, especially around health, because obviously what I went through, but I'm, you mm-hmm. know, just all the experiences that I had in my life, like I can handle pretty much anything. But yeah, like that's like my biggest passion right now. Mm-hmm. So that's what I do. I've been working with some clients and, you know, out there prospecting and building a business, which, you know, sometimes that takes some time.
Yeah, it does. Can attest to that.
Yeah,
but working on it.
It's just a matter of like enjoying the journey, and absolutely. So I am enjoying it. It's like fun. I get out of like when I don't wake up to alarm clocks anymore, and it's nice. I like wake up at like 6-7 in the morning.
Good for you.
I'm like, yeah, I know, right? It's like startle.
Yeah.
So it's great. I actually wake up and I'm like excited to get my day started. You know,
So what's your vision with what you're doing right now, being a coach?
My vision is to just, I want to touch every human being that I possibly can, you know. I want to empower others to find their inner power, and really with that, just get there. That's like my mission. Get to their happy place. Get to their life full of joy. My motto is live your life to the fullest. That's literally like my tagline in anything. And it was that before the whole brain tumor thing. So I was like, ah, look at this. Like it's exactly what it
needs to be. The universe really tested you with that one.
Yeah, right? And then, so Free to Be Me is the name. Free to Be Me 23 is the name of my business. Mm-hmm. Excuse me. Free to Be Me is, I became free to be me after my brain tumor situation and my rebirth. And so therefore I'm wanting others to be free to them to be themselves as well. So that's my vision. And then with that, I'd love to do this type of stuff. So my goal is to be able to have different talks here and there and whatnot alongside with, you know, obviously coaching one-on-one.
Oh my goodness. There's so many things running through my head right now in regards to like what you are examples of. Obviously forgiveness, finding peace for yourself, turning the other cheek, so to say, living life to the fullest, like taking a situation that wasn't very hard situation and literally making the best out of it. Mm-hmm. Choosing that, no, this is what I want for me, you are not going to dictate what's going to happen to me, and you've turned it into something so incredibly beautiful.
Thank you.
How can people get in touch with you?
Oh, yeah. So, I mean, I'm all over social media. I do have a website as well. It's freetobeme23, all spelled out, .com. And then I have my email, freetobeme23@outlook.com. My phone number, I don't know if I should...
That's entirely up to you. What you feel comfortable sharing on the world wide web.
I don't mind sharing it. It's also on the website, so I'm like, people can definitely contact me there as well. But yeah, for even daily inspirations, I would say, you know, follow me on Instagram. Again, free to be me 23. And, you know, Facebook as well. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, I'm just taking over Free to Be Me 23. And 23, just so people know why I chose 23. 23, it was always been my favorite number just because I was born on that day. Okay. 123. And then the day I went for my MRI was August 23rd. So, mm-hmm. again, 823. My dog was born on June 23rd. And then I looked it up because 23 and me, you know, and I was like, why mm-hmm. do they use 23? Come to find out, it's like, you know, to be human, that's like the number of pair of chromosomes, you yep. know, and I was like, oh my God, perfect, 23. Like, I'm here for the human beings in this world, so.
And it rhymes with the three.
Yeah, I know, I know. It's just like, I'm like, oh my God, this just came into like, yeah, it all came, you know, came together organically. It wasn't like I like forced it or anything.
Awesome, that's so cool. So definitely check her out, reach out to her if you need some type of like uplifting empowerment. I mean, look at what she's doing with her life. This is really, really incredible. I'm so glad to have met you.
Oh,
and
you
I'm
too.
Thrilled that you're able to come on the show with all the craziness you have going on with your healing. And it's great to see your journey and see you go. I mean, I've only known her for a couple of months, but just to see where she's come from and how far she's going, it's absolutely incredible. So free
you.
To be me, 23, Instagram, Outlook.
Outlook.
Yes. At outlook.com for email, and then your website, free to be me 23. Anuschka, thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
Of course.
Yeah.
And I know I said this is my last live show. However, I will have content posted throughout the rest of the year. So stay posted. Until then. Yeah, just we're waiting for a baby to be born, yeah. So that'll be the next big thing. So you'll be hearing from me hopefully very soon. Bye, guys.